Perfect. As a lot of you guys seem to be interested in tutorial videos for Rocket League, I start a series called Locals Rocket League Academy. In this series, I will go over different mechanics, in-game tips, and much more, starting with the famous flip reset. In case you're new to this channel, my name is Local, I'm a high-level Rocket League player with several thousands of hours of experience in the game. Make sure to subscribe to the channel for awesome content and like this video right now so it will be shown to a lot of new people. Now let's get to the intro of the series and welcome to Locals Rocket League Academy.
It's Locals Rocket League Academy, the best gaming channel on the web. Are you ready to learn Master Flick and Flip Reset? Let's get you started right here at Locals Rocket League Academy.
The flip reset. It's a mechanic known to almost every single Rocket League player nowadays. Moreover, it's a common move for pro players as well as freestylers to do. Its concept is relatively simple compared to other mechanics in a game. You just need to make sure all four wheels of your car touch the ball at the same time. When this happens, you will have your first flip again. If you haven't noticed yet, you basically have two flips or jumps in Rocket League. One for jumping off the ground and one for an aerial flip, but you will lose the second one pretty fast. That's why you want to reset your flip, because you will have unlimited time to use your first flip again. Alright, but what's the easiest way to get a simple flip reset? Start by gently rolling the ball towards a wall of your choice. Keep some distance when the ball is about to reach the ramp, then speed up and hit the ball when it went past the ramp to make it pop towards the ceiling. The ball must not touch the ceiling though. Brake a little to get some distance to the ball, then accelerate, boost, and eventually jump off the wall to fly towards the ball. The faster you fly to the ball, the easier it is to get a flip reset. Right before touching the ball, you need to turn your car upside down so your wheels face the ball. Then you should have it, a flip reset. After trying this, you might notice that you can't do much with it, because your car is completely out of position to hit the ball properly with the flip you just got. How can you align your car properly to get a shot on target after a flip reset? Well, you shouldn't touch the ball right on its bottom. You also shouldn't get the reset on top of the ball. These are common mistakes for beginners. There's a certain spot on the ball that's basically made for flip resets. It is right between the bottom and the front of the ball. If you get to touch the ball there with all four wheels of your car, I guarantee that you get a perfect flip reset with the best possibility to follow the ball afterwards and get a shot on target. Quick pro tip. Try to get the flip reset while the ball is flying towards the ceiling, or at least before it loses height. By doing that, you will have so much time to decide what you're doing with the flip reset. You can practice flip resets in the free play, but it might be easier to use a wall-to-air dribble or some sort of off-wall training pack for this. My two favorite training packs to practice this mechanic are, as always, in the video description. There's nothing more to say about a simple flip reset. If you have any questions about this topic, I'd love to chat with you about it in the comments. Also, let me know about other mechanics that you want to see in Locals Rocket League Academy. If you want to chat with me about any other topics, make sure to join my Discord today. That's it, guys. Have fun practicing a flip reset, and I hope I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.